left foot comes forward in a bend, right foot goes out to the side. Hips are square to the front. When you're ready, hands on hips, hands to heart center, and arms float up to the sky with a good stretch in those thighs. Our legs about 3 feet apart, preparing for goddess pose. So goddess pose is a bent, you feel it in your legs, and arms go up to the cactus or goalpost arms, just like that. Let yourself just drop, feeling the strength in those legs. Good job. We're going to take a pivot to the right, with our goddess arms, back to center. Inhale, pivot to the left, and back to center. Let those feet point out to either corner of the mat, and let your legs straighten and stretch up to star position. Good job. Keeping your navel pulled in, back stretch, but really stretch those arms. Feel it in your core. And then adjust your feet, bend those knees, arms come back to goddess. Good job. Hands are splayed open, fingers. Take a tilt to the right, to the center, to the left. Point those feet a little bit and push up to star. Good job. One more time for goddess. Adjust your feet. Once again with a twist to the right. Center. And to the left. And one last star. Job. You can come together, either step or move your feet together. We're going to come to a standing wide-legged fold. So once again, let's take our feet out to the side. We're going to bend from the waist. Hands kind of follow the contour of our legs down towards the ankles. That and left forward, wide-legged forward. Breathing in and out. If you're comfortable with your head hanging heavy, go right ahead. If for your balance, if you have to look, that's fine too. As you exhale, maybe you can reach those arms down farther. Slowly and carefully let yourself come back up. You might feel just a little bit dizzy. And toe in your feet together. We're going to move to garland pose, which is a deeper of a squat. Our feet are not quite as close together. Hands come to heart center. And you more or less just do a squat as far as you are comfortable in doing. Some people can almost sit down. Good job. Remembering to breathe. And when you're ready, come back up again. And let's shake our hands. Take a breath in and out. And then let's meet again for garland pose one more time. Yourself a good shake. let's do our mountain here. So let's ground in so we have a good foundation for our mountain. Hands are outside. Spine straight. Nice and tall. Crown of the head to the ceiling. If you're ready, hands come to heart center. And let's put our hands up. Fingertips touch and fingers interlace. And then let's turn them in the opposite direction. And let's do a back bend. And then to the front, to the right side, to center, and to the left. Back to the center. Unlace your hands, palms together, hands to heart center. Good job. We're going to come to a forward fold, so let yourself hang down. Half lift. And back down again. And we're going to turn. I'm going to turn because I'm doing the other way. Prepare for down dog. So when you're ready, let's prepare for down dog. Let's do that stretch out again of our legs. See if you can pedal them out. Left foot steps over the right. Give it a stretch there. Back to center. Right foot comes over the left. Give it a good stretch. And this time, we're going to bring our right leg forward as we come down to pigeon. If you're comfortable with pigeon being pushed up in your arm, is fine. But if you'd like to stretch a little bit more, you can come down like this for pigeon. You will feel it right here in your hip joint. Come back to mat. Let's tuck that left set of toes that we have. Push back and prepare for down dog again. This time, left foot crosses over, and we bring that left foot, that left thigh forward for our pigeon. Once again, this is fine. If you need more of a stretch, let yourself come down. Remembering to breathe in and out. If you're ready, you can just let yourself transition to a seated position. We're going to move to cobbler or butterfly. We're going to let the soles of our feet meet together. And our hands will be on our ankles here. And we let the legs just naturally, let gravity take care of letting them come to the mat. And this is also called the butterfly pose. So if you want to flutter those legs and stretch them, please feel free to do that. We're going to let each leg go up to the corner of the mat, as wide as you're comfortable with. And we're also going to let ourselves bend from the waist. Hands come forward.
a wide legged forward fold in a seated position. If you can, you can reach out to each hand to an ankle to make the forward fold deeper. Remembering to breathe in and out. And let yourself slowly rise. And let's do one more forward fold down, either to the front to begin with, and then taking your arms out to either side. As you exhale, let yourself come down. And let yourself come back up. You're going to do the baby cradle pose. So you just want to think that you're left arm is going to hold this baby right here, which is your left leg. So we're going to cradle that knee and the elbow of your left arm. And we're going to take your foot, and we're just going to do circles with it. Which either direction you start in is fine. Just know that we're going to reverse it then. This really gets the synovial fluid moving in the hip joint. Switch legs. Just cradle that right leg in your right elbow. And then yourself move this leg around off this baby. I'm hearing popping in mine. That's neither good nor bad. It's just the sound my hip joint makes. And then the opposite direction if you haven't done that yet. Then from here, we're going to let ourselves lie back. And give a good hug into the chest of our knees. And you can windshield wiper those legs. When you're ready, put your arms up on either side. Let those legs fall to the right. And your gaze look over to the left. And returning to the center of your neck, those knees. Pull them into your chest again. Give a rock from side to side. And when you're ready, arms go out in T position, and those legs go over to the left, gaze to the right. Turning to the center of the mat. Let your legs go up. If you need to hold them behind your knees, you can. Just let's get the circulation reversed a little bit. So legs up the wall. You can also put a block underneath your back. It gives you a little more elevation. We're going to let our legs open up, knees come wide, grab your toes if you're comfortable, and happy baby. You can just hold your toes and just let your back relax and look up and around. And in your home, if you would like to prepare for Savasana, you can dim the lights and prepare yourself for our final time here together on the mat. from Happy Baby, you can let your legs go down and check in with yourself.
Let yourself melt into that mat.
As you're lying there,
I'd like to repeat the finger breath again. So if you have your left hand available, put it out. Take that right index finger, starting at the pinky with an inhale, and exhale down. And continue through the rest of the fingers that you have on your hand. Thinking about the uniqueness of your hands and your breath, how they work together to get things done. And when you come to the thumb on that left hand, inhale and reverse. Completed. Put that right hand out. Index finger on the left hand, starting with the pinky. Inhaling up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. And reverse when you get to the thumb. And if you're finished, just put your hands wherever they're most comfortable for you during this final time. Check in with yourself. Are there any places that need a little more motion or relaxation? If they do, try and adjust for that. How does your neck feel? Your jaw? Soften your eyes. Shoulders, let them relax. Coming down to the chest, let it soften and relax. Let that spine melt into the mat. Coming down to your hips that really worked hard today. Maybe you want to give them just a little movement. Maybe you need to do a little twist in the legs again in the joint. Those knees, do you need to bend them? You can do a windshield wiper if that feels good, or another hug in if your back needs another knees to chest pull in that area. The calf muscles. Maybe you need to move your feet a little bit. Wiggle those toes and let yourself relax. God has given us eyes not to judge others, but to look beyond situations. A mouth not to criticize, but to speak the truth. Ears not to be sensitive, but to listen and believe
and aid those in pain. And hands, not to punish, but to give a helping hand. Everything God gave us has its purpose. Use them for the greater glory of the Lord. When you can't control what's happening, challenge yourself to control the way you respond to what's happening. That is where your power is. Away from negative vibes today. Don't let them spoil your day. This time you can let yourself become a little more aware of your surroundings. Let yourself check in. Maybe have a little movement to your head from side to side. Your shoulders, feet, wrists, your fingers. And if you feel ready, let yourself turn to one side or the other in the position of the dreaming child. And if you feel ready, you can return to your favorite easy seated position, whatever that may be. And let's join in together with a deep breath in. And exhale, let your chin come to your chest. The next breath, let your arms come up with your inhalation. Hands meet together. Exhale, chin comes to chest. Dear Lord, it's time to just be happy. Being angry, sad, and overthinking isn't worth it anymore. Lord, please help us just let things flow and be positive. Thank you for this time together today, Lord. Thank you for Aaron and Fred. And thank you for this beautiful day. In your name we pray. Amen. And I thank all of you for joining us today for Yoga at Sankey's. I hope this helped open up your hips, and I hope you remain positive today. Thank you.